गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू 10th क्लास इंग्लिश क्लास। प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लोचिनवा, लेट्स कंटिन्यू। कंप्लीटली हाफ पोयम वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, लेट अस स्टार्ट। लोचिनवा वाज अ सॉरी लोकिनवा वाज अ ब्रेव एंड वेरी एनर्जेटिक। ही केम टू नेदरबाय हॉल टू मैरी अ व्हाट इज हर नेम ब्राइड along good. The characters here are Lochinvar, Alan. Alan's father, mother are present. Alan's father, mother and cousins also present in the Netherby hall. Bridegroom, bridegroom is going to marry with the Lochinvar and the relatives, those who came for the marriage, relatives. There is a marriage of bridegroom. There is no name given of the bridegroom and the Lochinvar. So Lochinvar came from the west direction. We have seen in the previous class how he came. Fourth paragraph, let's I will read. I long would your daughter, my suit you deny. Means I am in love with your daughter. I have asked you and I have requested you to give your daughter, but you have denied. Means rejected. This has been said by the Lochinvar to the Alan's father. यहाँ पे ये Lochinvar ने एलन के फादर को बता रहे कि मैं पहले भी आपकी बेटी को बेटी का हाथ मान लिए थे, बट आपने रिजेक्ट करे थे। लव स्पेल्स लाइक अ सॉल्वे, सॉल्वे आई हैव टोल्ड यू सॉल्वे इज अ रिवर। लव किसके जैसा है? ए एक रिवर के जैसा है। एंड एक्स लाइक इट्स टाइड, मीन्स इट्स गोइंग, एक्स मीन्स डिक्रीज, इट्स गोइंग टू डिक्रीज जस्ट लाइक अ tides, waves you all know, you have seen. And now I am, and he is telling, now I come with this lost love of mine. Maine apne pair kho diya hai yahan pe, I lost my love, so I have not came here to marry your daughter Ellen. So I lost my love, maine apne pair kho diya hai. To lead but one measure. क्यों आया मैं यहाँ पे? Measure means dance. Measure means it's not a measurement. Measure means dance. I want to dance with Ellen. I want to dance with Ellen. And drink one cup of wine. Dance करने का है मुझे और एक कप wine पीने का है। There are maidens in Scotland more lovely by far. Scotland में बहुत सारे लड़कियां हैं। Maidens means young women. So many young women are there in Scotland to marry me. That would gladly be bride to be a young Lochinvar. Up to here we have discussed. Let us see what happens with the Ellen and Lochinvar. So the bride kisses the goblet. The knight took it up. Goblet means wine glass. Who is bride here? Ellen is the bride. Ellen, bride. What is the meaning of bride and bridegroom? Bride, dulhan. Bridegroom, dulha. Bride, madhimagalo. Bridegroom, madhimaga. Dulhan or dulha. Dulhan kaun thi yahan pe? Ellen. The bride is the goblet. Goblet means the wine glass. She took the wine glass and she kissed it to the glass. The knight took it up. Who is knight here? Lochinvar. Who is knight here? Knight is nothing but the soldier, brave soldier we can say. He took the glass. He quaffed off the wine and he threw down the cup. He took the glass which the Alan has been kissed to that glass. He took the glass and he drank very quickly. Quaffed off means gatta gatta ne kudiyodu anta helthunu. Quaffed off means drank the wine very fast. Glass to Alan ke haath mein tha. उन्होंने वो ग्लास को किस किया, करने के बाद लोकिन मार ने वो लेके पूरा वाइन पी लिया. एंड ही थ्रो डाउन आफ्टर दैट फिनिश्ड द आफ्टर व्हेन ही फिनिश्ड द वाइन ही थ्रो डाउन द ग्लास. शी लुक डाउन टू ब्लश. शी लुक नाउ एलन वाज लुकिंग टू द लोकिन मार. देन एलन लुक टू द लोकिन मार एंड ब्लश. ब्लश मींस shy. And she looked up to Sai. She looked to blush. She became very shy. You know that why she became very shy. And she looked up the Sai of the Lokin Mall with a smile on her lips. After this situation, then she kissed the glass, and that glass has been looked by the Lokin Mall, and he drank the wine which is present in that glass. After that, the Ellen became very shy. Nachke ante odiga adanna glass anna tan kiss madid glass anna tagond kudididanna nodi bhala nachke agutte avalige. Nachke nu pattkondu ond kade nattidale mattond kade en maadtidale avu kanlininda neer harita ide. Neer kanlininda neer surita ide. He took her so and tear in her eye. Ond kade nattidale mugullage kaanista ide, mattond kade kannalli neer kaanisukottidale. He took her soft hand. He means he refers to Lokin Mall here. He took her soft hand of the Ellen. Ere means before. This is the old form of English. Ere means before. He took her soft hand and her mother could bar. Mother wants to drag her daughter. Then Thayi avalan hidudu elukobe kandittu. Astralle the Lokin Mall came and took her hand. So the mother can't do anything. He took her soft hand and her mother could bar. Now treat me a measure. Means now we are going to measure. M-E-A-S-U-R-E. M-E-A-S-U-R. Measure means dance. Now, Lokin Mall took her hand, took Ellen's hand, and he wants to dance now. Tread means move round. Tread. T-R-E-A-D. Tread means move round. Move. But by moving round, they wants to dance now. Said and Lokin Mall. See here. Each and every paragraph end with the Lokin Mall. Now treat me a measure, said young Lokin Mall. Now we are going to do dance. He came. He said that he came to. He came there to dance with the Ellen and to drink a cup of wine. So next paragraph. So stately his form and so lovely her face. That never a hall such a gallant did grace. The dance was very beautiful. The relatives, the cousins, those who are going to watch the dance, which are made by Lokin Mall and Ellen, they said that before in the Netherby Hall, this kind of dance has not been seen. इससे पहले Netherby Hall में ऐसा dance कभी भी नहीं देखे थे. The dance which was done by Ellen and Lokin Mall. That never a hall such a gallant did grace. Means dance with complicated steps. The measure means the dance which has made by Lokin Mall was with the difficult steps. ऐसा पहले कभी भी वहां पे देखे ही नहीं थे. So that much difficult dance was that. Why her mother did fret? Fret means ghabrana. Mother was very fear because the marriage is with the bridegroom. Shaadi hone wala dulha to kahan to corner mein baitha hai. So dance is going with the local one. So the mother, the parents, they are going to frighten. घबरा गए थे माँ तो बहुत घबरा गए. While her mother did fret and her father did fume. पापा को तो बहुत गुस्सा आ गया यहाँ पे. Because the daughter, she is doing dance with the local one. While her mother did fret and her father did fume. And the bridegroom stood dancing his bonnet and plume. The bridegroom, who is bridegroom here? He wants to marry the Ellen. Ellen के साथ शादी करने वाला दूल्हा. ये तो दूर खड़े होके देख रहा था डांस को. So यहाँ पे bridegroom के बारे में क्या बताया देखो. The bridegroom stood dangling. Dangling means just like moving like this. Dangling. नेता लोग dangling his bonnet and plume. Bonnet means he had a cap. Here they have not given the cap is on the head or not, but the cap is there. For that cap, fume is there. Fume means what we are going to say. Gari ante yochidu. A topi ki on kade sanna dagi baachirta vala cap. That type of fume is there with that cap. By that cap he is dangling. And the bride maidan whispered. Bride. Who is bride here? Ellen is the bride. Bride maidan. Bride maidan means the relatives, the cousins of the bride whispered that twere better by far. Twere better by far means they both are made for each other. Who? Lokinbar and Ellen. The cousins, they told that, the relatives, they told that they both are made for each other. By seeing that dance, that perfect dance, by seeing that dance, all they judged that the Ellen should marry with the Lokinbar, not with the bridegroom. Because Lokinbar was made for each other. So they said, twere better by far means made for each other. To have matched. Lokinbar is matched with the Ellen. Match our fair cousin. Fair cousin means fair cousin is refers to Ellen here. Ellen was, she was very fair and beautiful. Cousin with young Lokinbar. He is very perfect match for the Ellen. Cousins has been told there by seeing the dance with the Lokinbar. So let's come to the next paragraph. One touch to her hand. One touch to her hand and one word in her ear. One hand is touched to the Ellen and one word he spoke in her ear. एक ही वर्ड बता दिए थे उसके कान में. किसके कान में? एलन के कान में. एक हाथ उसको एलन को टच करे और उसके बाद समथिंग ही हैज बीन टोल्ड इन हर ईयर. हर ईयर. व्हेन दे रीच्ड द हॉल डोर एंड द चार्जर स्टूड नियर. बाय डांसिंग दे रीच्ड टू द नेदर बाय हॉल. Hall door means that is the exit door, we can say. There stood a charger. Here charger means not a charger. The charger here is a horse which is used in the battle. जो battle में horse use करते ना उसको charger बता दिए यहाँ पे. So after the door, the charger was stood there. The charger was standing there. When they reached the hall door and the charger stood near the door. So light to the crowd, the fair lady she swam. When they crossed the door and the lady, who is called lady here? Ellen. Ellen jumped on that charger. Ellen ne door pass karke charger ke upar baith gayi. So light to the saddle. Saddle means the place which has been on the horse. Baithne ka jagah horse ke upar. So light to the saddle before her he sprang. She is one. the people, those who the relatives, the cousins, those who are there in the nearby hall, they told that she is one. Means they both jumped from the door and they sat on the charger and they went away. She is gone, we are gone, over bank, bush and spot. Soon after they went, most of the people, they started to follow them, but they are very far away. She is one, we are one, over bank, bush and scarves, means steep rock. They, up to the rocks, they reach. They will have fleet steeds that follow. What end looking boy. They will have fleet steeds that follow and looking bird. So they passed from the door and when so many those who are present in the nearby hall, the relatives, the cousins, the neighbors, they all followed to the looking bird and Ellen, but they couldn't find out the looking bird and Ellen. They are very far away. Then let's come to the last paragraph. There was mountain. Mountain means rising higher point. Among grapes means very angry of the nearby clan. Forsters, Fenwings and Musgraves. So don't confuse. All these names are of the scar means steep rock. Crow means behind the saddle on the horseback. Behind the saddle on the horseback. Fleet steeds means swift horses. Greens, Forsters, Fenwings, Musgraves are the names of the various clans, means the name of the people supporting the lord of Netherby Hall. The people of the Netherby Hall, we can say. So there was morning, means they went with the higher point. Greens, angry of the Netherby clan, Forsters, Fenwings and Musgraves, they rode to the ram. All these people, they followed the looking bird. There was racing and chasing on Conobili, means that's the name of a hill. They all followed, most of the people, they followed the up to the Konobi hill. That is the name of a hill. Wahan tak sabhi log looking bird aur Ellen ko follow kare. But the lost bride of Netherby, Neer, N-E-E-R. Neer means never. They lost the bride of Netherby, never did they see. They lost the bride of the Netherby hall, that is Ellen. She never been seen there. So daring in love. Who is having that much daring in love? That is looking for. I am so dauntless in war. Dauntless means very courageous. Courageous in war. Have you ever heard of gallant knight and looking boy? Here means, that is boy E-E-E-R. This is the meaning is, you ever. This Y-E refers to you, E-E-R refers to ever. This is the old form of English. Have you ever heard the gallant like end looking bird? Aap kabhi to aisa sune kya? Aisa end and a brave and a very courageous gallant like a looking bird. Aap kabhi to aisa sune kya bolke pooch rahe hain yahan pe. Like this, this is a story of a end, the brave looking bird and Ellen. Just I will read out once again. Listen to this from the first paragraph. O Eng Lokinwar, is come out of the west through all the wide border. His street was the best, and save his good broadsword, he weapons had none. He rode all unarmed, and he rode all alone. So faithful in love, and so dauntless in war. He was very faithful in love and fearless in war. He came from the west direction. So there never be knight like a knight. Knight means brave soldier, we can say. His stain means stopped not for a break, and he stopped not for a stone. He swam as river where ford there was none, but air means before. He alighted at Netherby Gate, that is in the England. This is the story of the border between the Scotland and England. Gallant came late, for a laggard in love and dastard in war. Was to wed the fair Ellen of brave Lochinvar. Was to wed the fair Ellen of brave Lochinvar. So badly he entered the Netherby Hall among bridesmen and kinsmen and brothers and all. Then spoke the bride's father, his hand on his sword, for the poor craven bridegroom said never a word. Oh, come you in peace here, or come you in war, or to dance at our bridal and lord Lochinvar. I long to dear daughter, my suit you denied. Love smells like a solvent, but ebb like its tide. And now I come with this lost love of mine, to lead but one measure's drink, one cup of wine. There are maidens in Scotland more lovely by far, that would gladly be bride to the young Lochinvar. The bride kissed the goblet, the knight took it up. He quaffed off the wine, and he threw down the cup. She looked down to blush, and she looked up to sigh, with a smile on her lips and a tear in her eye. He took a soft hand before her mother could bow. Now, tread we measure, said young Lochinvar. So stately his form, and so lovely her face, that never a hall such a gallier did grace. While her mother did fret and her father did fume, and the bridegroom stood dabbling his bonnet and plume. Bonnet is nothing but a cap. And the bride maidens whispered, fair better by far, to have matched with her fair cousin with young Lochinvar. One touch to her hand and one word in her ear. When they reached the hall door and the charger stood near, so light to the crowd the fair lady he swung. Oh, so light to the saddle before her he sprung. She is won, we were born, our bank bush and score. They will have fleet streets that follow, quack and Lochinvar. There was mounting mom greens of the Netherby clan, fosters, fenkits and musgraves. They rode and they ran. There was a racing and chasing on Hobney Lee, but the lost bride of Netherby never did they see. So daring in love and so dauntless in war. Have you ever heard the gallant like young Lochinvar? This is the story of Lochinvar. And some of the questions are given. So go through that. So it's a wonderful story. So some of the words are difficult. Go through the story and read it once or twice, you will get understood. Some of the difficult words are there, I have told you already. I know grammar part. go through the question answers. I have already sent you the solution. So write all the question answers. In the next class, we will go for the next poem. Thank you.